हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर वेलकम इन सीक्वेंस एंड सीरीज पार्ट 12। वी आर डूइंग मिसलिनियस एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। सो नाउ इट इज थर्ड क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज। सम ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट इज सम ऑफ n, 2n एंड 3n टर्म्स ऑफ n ap आर s1, s2, s3 रेस्पेक्टिवली। शो दैट s3 इज इक्वल टू 3 इंटू s2 माइनस s1। सो यू So this is AP, so you mind it, read the statement carefully. So let A is the first term of AP, D is the common difference, then S1 is the sum of N terms. So it is N upon 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. This is sum of N terms, the first N terms, using formula SN is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. And the same formula that will be used in this question. S2 is the sum of 2n terms. Number of terms are 2n now. So 2n upon 2 into 2a plus 2n minus 1 into d. Similarly, S3 the sum of first 3n terms. Number of terms 3n. So 3n upon 2 into 2a plus 3n minus 1 into d. Now we want to prove this statement. So we will simplify right hand side by putting the values of S2 and S1, and we will prove that equal to S3. So right hand side is 3 into S2 minus S1. You put values 3 into, this is S2, this is S1. The values are substituted from these two equations, and you take first common, n by 2 is common. So we are left here 2 into, so after multiplication 4a plus 4n minus 2 into d, and minus, similarly it is 2a, so we can multiply minus inside, so this sign will be changed, n minus 1 into d. And now after simplification you will find it 2a plus 3n minus 1 into d, which is s3. So that's why 3 into s2 minus s1 is equal to s3. I hope it is clear. Now question number 6. Find the sum of all 2-digit numbers which when divided by 4 yields 1 as remainder. So 2-digit number which gives 1 remainder when divided by 4. So required number, the first 2-digit number divisible by 4 is 12. The number which you give 1 as remainder will be 13. You add 1 to 12, so 13. Now for the next number add 4 to it, so it is 17. Then 21 and so on. The last 2-digit number will be 97. It will give 1 remainder when divided by 4. Now these terms are in AP, we can clearly identify. So A is the first term, which is 13. Common difference is 4. This 97, let it is nth term. We will first find out the value of n, and then we will find out their sum. So nth term is 97. So nth term using formula can be written as a plus n minus 1 into d. So you put values of a and d, value of n will be 22 after simplification. Now we want sum of these terms. Less s is the sum, 13 plus 17 plus 21 up to 97. So here a is 13, l last term is 97, and n is 22. So you apply the formula of sum of n terms of AP. So n by 2, 22 upon 2 into A plus L. And after simplification, it gives 1210 as answer. I hope it is clear. Now move on to question number 7. F of x plus y, if it is equal to fx into fy, for all xy belongs to n, that is natural numbers only. F1 is 3, find and summation of fx where x varies from 1 to n is 120, find n. Now f1 is given to us, f2 we will find out, f2 2 can be written as 1 plus 1. Using this formula, f of 1 plus 1 is equal to f1 into f1. F1 is given 3, so 3 into 3 it is 9. Now find out f3, 3 can be written as 1 plus 2. And using this formula, it is f1 into f2. So put the values, it is 27. So 27, it is third term. Now summation of fx x varies from 1 to n, it is 120 given to us. It means we will change the values of x 1 to n. So first x equal to 1, that is f1. If you put x2, it is second term f2, then f3, and so on up to fn, it is given 120. We have calculated first three terms, f1 is 3, f2 is 9, f3 is 27, and so on up to n terms. So this is GP having common ratio R, that is 3, which is greater than 1. So sum of n terms formula will be applied where R is greater than 1. So this is applied application of the formula 3 into 3 raised to the power n minus 1 upon 3 minus 1. It is equal to 120 given to us. And you solve this, after simplification you will find n is equal to 4. I hope it is clear. Then it is question number 10. Sum of three numbers in a GP is 56. If we subtract 1, 7 and 21 from the numbers in order, we obtain an AP. Find the numbers. Let the numbers are A, AR, AR square, three numbers. Now their sum is given 56. So A plus AR plus AR square is equal to 56. It is first equation. Then you subtract 1, 7 and 21 from these numbers. Subtract 1 from the first number, subtract 7 from the second and 21 from the third. Then these three numbers will be in AP. So using the concept of AP, middle term is arithmetical mean of remaining two. So it means 2 times of middle term AR minus 7 is equal to A minus 1 plus AR square minus 21, sum of the remaining two. So now you can simplify, you will find an equation, AR square minus 2AR plus A is equal to 8, mark it as number 2. So solve first and second equation, and after solution you will find AR is equal to 16. Then value of A will be 16 upon R. Now you put value of A in the first equation and we will get this quadratic equation, 16 upon R plus 16 plus 16 R is equal to 56. So after taking LCM, we will get a quadratic equation, 2R square minus 5R plus 2 is equal to 0. By splitting the middle term, factorize, and value of R will be R is equal to 2 and R is 1 by 2. So you put value of R 2 in this and find out A. So corresponding value of A will be 8. Similarly, when R is 1 by 2, the corresponding value of A will be 32. Using these two, find out the terms. Using initially we have assumed A, AR, AR square. So put in this, add and calculate 8, 16 and 32. These are the three required numbers. Similarly, R 1 by 2 and A 32. So find out the three number, that will be 32, 16 and 8. So these are two answers. Both will be correct. I hope it is clear. Then question number 13. If a plus b upon a plus bx upon a minus bx is equal to b plus cx upon b minus cx is equal to c plus dx upon c minus dx, show that a, b, c, d are in GP. So if a, b, c, d are in GP, it means we will prove their ratio, that is b upon a should be equal to c upon b should be equal to d upon c. If b upon a is equal to c upon b, it means we can prove that a upon b is equal to b upon c. So that is also correct. Now we are given this statement. In this, now you apply first componendo and dividendo. Applying componendo and dividendo, we know componendo and dividendo can be applied in an equator a plus bx plus denominator. You can simplify. After simplification, it will be 2a. Similarly, denominator 2bx. Use component and dividend in this part also. B plus cx plus b minus cx in numerator divided by b plus cx minus b minus cx in bracket in the denominator. So it, after simplification, 2b upon 2cx. Similarly, 2c upon 2dx. Now after cancellation, we will find out a upon b is equal to b upon c is equal to c upon d. So therefore we can say from this a, b, c, d are in GP, because they are ratios. If a upon b, we can write its reciprocal. It means B upon A will be equal to C upon B will be equal to D upon C. So therefore ABCD are in GP. You can conclude from here, there is no need to write this step. You can conclude that ABCD are in GP. I hope it is clear. Now 14th question. Let the numbers are A, AR, AR square. Now and so on. This is GP. We are given S as the sum of n terms. So sum of S, S is equal to A plus AR up to AR raised to the power n minus 1. After applying the formula, it is A into 1 minus R raised to the power n. So in this we have considered that R is less than 1. You can also consider R as greater than 1. So both will be correct. So we have considered here R less than 1. We are given in the statement P is the product of n terms. So P is the product means A into AR square up to AR raised to the power n minus 1. This is multiplication. So A into A n times will be A raised to the power n. R after adding powers R raised to the power 1 plus 2 up to n minus 1. So this is AP and we can find the sum of n minus 1 terms of AP after applying the formula. It will be n minus 1 into n upon 2. So R raised to the power, mark it as number 2 equation. This is number 1. Now in the question we are given R is the sum of reciprocals of the terms. Reciprocal of A is 1 upon A. Reciprocal of AR is 1 upon AR. So sum of n terms like this, that is R. Now in this equation, in this we have assumed R as less than 1. So if R is less than 1, then 1 upon R will be greater than 1. So in this the common ratio is 1 upon R. So therefore sum of n terms where common ratio greater than 1, that formula will be used. And this is after application of the formula and after simplification, it is R is equal to, mark it as number 3rd equation. Now we want to prove P square into R raised to the power n is equal to S raised to the power n. You solve left hand side, put value of P and R. P we have calculated there, this is P, and R we have calculated. So you put value of P and R and then simplify. So you will find equal to S raised to the power n. You try the simplification part and that's all for today. Thank you.